probably shouldn't be admitting this, but Xenoblade Recap Part 2 was actually supposed to come out over the past week, but, Fire Emblem happened. I'll try to get it out next week. It's completely recorded and just needs editing, but, I haven't finished one route yet, and I want to get all of them done before Astral Chain comes out, so, yeah, I make no promises. Anyway, though, you know me and my ongoing war against misinformation about Xenoblade-related things, and I'm gonna make this to try and temper the expectations from a rumor that's been starting up over the past week. Basically, it involves the fact that Adam Howden and Caitlin Glass, the voice actors for Shulk and Elma respectively, have teased working on new projects, and people are thinking, oh, this is connected, this is something related to Xenoblade where they would be playing those characters. This sounds really cool and like it could be plausible at first glance, but when you look at it, the two tweets that have been going around from the two of them have very different dates on them. The one from Caitlin Glass was November 8th, 2018, and the one from Adam Howden was July 30th, 2019. I don't know if I need to say this, but there's almost no way these could possibly be for the same project. I'm almost certain that this is just a case of someone seeing a couple things and jumping to conclusions as opposed to being really delusional about it, especially because the screenshots of the tweets that have been going around lacked the date for the one from Adam Howden. So there's that. But beyond the date stuff, I think I should go over a couple other reasons why this probably isn't the case. I'm mostly going to be focusing on Glass's tweet here because Howden's specifically talks about it being for a game, and there is a reasonable probability that it could be him actually playing Shulk for something that isn't the next Xenoblade game, while Glass's is almost certainly something completely unrelated. First off is the fact that it's an update to a previous tweet where she was talking about getting an audition, and the reference for the character she was auditioning for was for one that she already had voiced. This is a bit of a red flag to me because I wouldn't think she would have to audition again for Elma in the future. I don't really know how the process goes in the games industry as a whole, and especially the game dubbing industry, but I'd imagine that if Xenoblade X2 was announced and was being localized, whoever the localization team's casting or voice director was would approach Caitlin Glass first for the role of Elma and only open auditions for the character if she declined. I also highly doubt that Caitlin Glass would decline coming back to voice Elma in a future Xenoblade X game for a couple reasons. First off, she seems to have legitimately enjoyed voicing the character and wants to play her again at some point. I was even able to find a tweet where, when asked what her most wanted newcomer for Smash Ultimate was, she responded with Elma. And keep in mind, she also plays Cammy in Street Fighter, so there are multiple characters that had a non-zero chance of getting in Ultimate that she voices, and she picked Elma over the more well-known one. And secondly, Nintendo of Europe already went through a lot of trouble getting her back as Elma for the Xenoblade 2 DLC. To put things into perspective, let's just talk about all the other previous Xeno characters that cameoed in Xenoblade 2. Xenoblade 2 was localized in the UK like Xenoblade 1 was, so it makes perfect sense that the UK-based Adam Howden and Karina Reeves were able to return for Shulk and Fiora. Cosmos and Telos are a bit of a package deal because every time they appear together, they're voiced by the same person in both English and Japanese, and while Telos' only previous English voiced appearance was in Xenosaga Episode 3, Cosmos has actually been played by three different Americans over the years between multiple games and the anime. Despite having multiple Cosmoses to choose from, both androids were instead recast with the British Caitlin Thorburn for Xenoblade 2. So yeah, while the previously American-voiced Cosmos and Telos were recast with a Brit putting on the accent, Caitlin Glass still came back to play Elma, and this must have been incredibly difficult to work around logistics and legal-wise, having one voice actor on a completely different continent from literally everyone else who worked on the game. It is worth noting, though, that this isn't the first time something like this has had to happen, because Adam Howden and Karina Reeves both voice options for the Avatar in Xenoblade X, and I believe are the only not American-based voice actors in that game, so it's a bit of a reversal when a Xenoblade X character had to come into a UK localized game, which is kind of an interesting bit of trivia, but not relevant here. Anyway, going back to the original Caitlin Glass tweet, the other red flag is the fact that A character she voiced was the reference for this mystery audition, and she has been dubbing anime with Funimation since 2004, so there are a lot of characters this could be. While yes, the character being referenced could have been Elma, and it could have even been sound like Elma while re-auditioning for the part of Elma, it could have also been Kami, Vados, Nina, Winry, frickin' Maki from Love Live, so the chances of this actually being something Elma-related are pretty small. The only potential saving grace to this is that it looks like the terms of this NDA are still in effect because, as far as I could tell, no new anime, games, or what have you that she's voiced in have come out or been announced since this tweet. The only things have been voicing characters in continuations of previous series, so, like, continuing to voice a character that we'd already known she'd been playing since before this, and the fact that she is the ADR director for the Fruits Basket remake dub, but the tweet was specifically talking about a character as opposed to a directing position, so we do still technically not know what was being teased here. It's just the fact that it's almost certainly not Elma. So now, back to Howden's tweet, why do I think that this could still potentially be Shulk even if it's not a new Xenoblade game? Well, he's done voice work on games since 2009, and has worked on several pretty high-profile things that he might have fans for following him on Twitter, other than just Xenoblade, including the Dragon Age series and Final Fantasy XIV, but for the most part he seems to play bit parts or one-off characters, with Shulk being his most common recurring role, even if I think that's only the case because of his reused lines in Smash Ultimate. But either way, this could be Shulk for a future RPG crossover thing, or I guess technically a Xenoblade Chronicles HD port where they just added a few extra voice lines, like maybe voicing the heart-to-hearts to keep them in line with what Xenoblade 2 did. But I don't know, I'm leaning more on some sort of crossover thing where Shulk is just making a cameo. Although, yeah, technically it could be a new Xenoblade project, because I'm pretty sure it's a rule now that Adam Howden has to voice a character in every Xenoblade game's dub. But, again, voice acting is one of the last things that happens in the production cycle of a game, and dub voice acting even after that. I doubt the next Xenoblade title is complete to a point where the script is finalized enough for the dub actors to have rapped on their performances, so, you know. Besides Xenoblade, the one thing that I do think could be a definite possibility is a sequel to the 2013 Vita action RPG Soul Sacrifice, in which he played the main character. The only reason I'm saying this is because the game was designed by Keiji Inafune of all people, and he has expressed interest in wanting to do a sequel at some point, but, like, I don't know if anyone's gonna buy into a Keiji Inafune game ever again, so I don't know. But yeah, that's all I gotta say about this situation. Yes, Shulk and Elma's voice actors both teased something, but it's not the same something, and only one of them is likely to actually be their Xenoblade character, and even then, it's not likely to be a new Xenoblade game. But yeah, I gotta start recording tomorrow's video too, so goodbye.